She wants to save her marriage, but I'm not sure what she's about to do is ethical. Let's chew on this for a second here. Burt Show, need your help because I gotta do it today. I'm the manager of the accounting department in a rather large company. I oversee close to 20 employees, and I've been here for 12 years. I've fallen in love with one of my employees. I didn't mean for it to happen. I never saw it coming. He has, capital letters, no idea. I am married and have been for 7 years. I love my husband, but my connection with my employee is undeniable. This is not physical. This is real. And it's real distracting. I can't focus at work, and I know my thoughts of him are putting space between me and my husband. My husband asks me why I'm so distant, and I make all the cliche excuses. There is an opening in another office, and I have the authority to transfer him. He definitely has a more clear path to a better position and more money in my department, but I can't have this distraction in front of me every day. I'm struggling. Should I force the transfer today? I know it's not ethical, but I am positive if the situation remains the same, my life will change forever. Then in capital letters, please help! 1-855-BIRCHOW. Ooh, who wants to start on this one?
I mean, if she had a little indication from the other dude that this might be reciprocated, I mean, it's still wrong, but at least she hasn't acted on it yet.
Mm-hmm.
I think she needs to do a little soul searching as to why she's finding somebody else so attractive. Mm-hmm. And she is drawn to somebody else when she's married. I feel like the work needs to start at home before you pursue this relationship at work.
I think she's not even planning on pursuing this relationship at work. I think she's just like, I need to get it out of my face so I don't. And if I can just not see him every day, maybe that protects me from this temptation. Davi.
I think she needs to resign. I don't think she should be in her position anymore. For this to even be a letter written from someone superior is gross. And like, personally, I think when people can't control themselves, then something should be done to them to help control them. You know, in high school, dress codes. Why are girls being covered up when the boys can't control themselves? I don't think that the girls should have to call home and get pants or a long sleeve shirt brought to school because the boys are becoming a problem. Put chastity belts on the boys. Control the people that can't control themselves. And that's what she's doing right now. Mm. If this was a man, we would be disgusted. Mm-hmm. And I still am, because I don't think men and women are that different. And she can't control herself, so she's trying to pawn someone off into a lesser role, into less money, and completely jeopardize their future because she cannot control her urges. That's what this is.
Mo.
Yeah, I don't even think it's a question of if she needs to transfer this guy. Of course you don't. She should evaluate two things, and they both have to do with her position at work and her marriage, because it seems as if she shouldn't be in either one if she finds herself in a predicament of trying to make a decision like this. But I don't think her problems has anything to do with this guy.
Cassie.
It's interesting because every time I hear about somebody trying to put up, I think you call them guardrails, Bert, because mm-hmm. Andy Stanley called them that, protect their marriage. I love that. I think that is a selfless act because you're recognizing that there's some danger there and you're taking action. But what I hate is every time we have this conversation on the Burt Show, the person is so selfish. They have to punish the other person in order to keep themselves safe. And like Davi said, if you can't handle the heat, then get out the kitchen. If she can't be around this dude, that dude doesn't deserve to be punished for existing. Mm-hmm. Homegirl needs to leave and remove herself from the situation, not remove the problem.
Boy, my position is going to be unpopular. I think that she should transfer him and not say a word.
That's not fair to him.
Nope, it really is not. It's not fair to him at all. I understand what she's trying to do with her marriage, and she feels like she's going to be tempted. It is 100% not fair to him. 100%. I still think that she should transfer him and get him out of the office if it's going to jeopardize her marriage. But she's Go ahead.
Someone else will just come along and take that position that she might end up having those feelings for again. Like, this is something within her wrong, and she's trying to jack up someone else's future because of it. Like, She needs therapy. She needs to be home mm-hmm. with her husband. She needs to work on her relationship. Like, someone else is going to come along that's going to tweak the temptation again.
We don't know that. All we know is that she's been there for 12 years, and she doesn't say that this has happened before. So let's just assume, for debate's sake, this is really, really super unique. But I agree with everything else you're saying. Yeah, she got some work to do on herself, for sure.
Like, as a superior, if this is where she ethically is, like, she's okay with this and it's even a thought, I just imagine it happening again because she's, like, powerful and untouchable at this point.
Bobby, you know, you can't help who you fall in love with is the cliche, which I think is BS.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
Yes, you can.
Yes, you can. You can transfer them to another office.
No!
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 Nah, man.
Jordan, good morning. You are part of the Burt Show. Hi.
Hey, how are you, man?
Excellent. How are you today?
Pretty good, man. Pretty good.
What do you think here?
What I was going to say is I feel like she should just focus on her marriage. I mean, you guys covered it all, but I feel like she should just focus on her marriage and focus on that first and then, you know, take a vacation away from the office because the man has nothing to do with it. What if he doesn't feel the same for her? Like, he has nothing to do with this.
Literally, the only thing he is doing is existing.
Yeah. Right. He's just so sexy when he's making those copies. It's not fair, Kristen. She can't control herself.
All right, so Davi, you say leave the company. Leave Pride Rock. Never return.
I say resign. You're not responsible or mature enough to have your position.
Mo, where you at?
Yeah, leave the company, leave your husband, find yourself, and then find everybody else. That's where I'm at with it.
Kristen.
I say acknowledge that you need work. You can stay at work, but start talking to somebody and start working on your marriage at home. You just need to find your inner strength, and it's there. You're just going to have to get people to help you find it.
The Burt Show.